Hey, this is Ralph. In this video, we're going to keep working on this navigation menu with cover-up text, similar to what they have over here at soloshot.com. Okay, so this is the effect we want to try to mimic a little bit here. And this is where I left off in the last video. I've got the anchor tags and I'm showing three images. Now I need to do that cover-up on hover. So back over on the code. Oh, keep in mind, on the HTML, the cover-up card is basically going to be this span right here. So I'm going to take those spans and style those next. They're inside of my list items. So within nav3, span. I'm going to go ahead and make these into block elements. And like I've done with several other things here, I'm going to size them appropriately. 240 by 160, which is the exact size of the anchor tags. And I will go ahead and do a background color. This one I'm going to do RGBA, and I will do, RGB, let's do 0, 0, 255, that's bright blue, and I'll do a 0.5 semi-transparent. And I'm just going to, sit with that for a second, and you're not going to see anything too exciting yet, because my hover text is all the way down here at the bottom. So I do need to take care of this. I'm going to have to position absolute, need a semicolon up there, and I'll put these at the top 0px, left 0px. And since I'm positioning these spans absolutely, I need to make sure that the list items themselves are position relative. So now we can see those cards where they're meant to be. Now that's not where I want them to be in the original state, that's only in the hover state, but I can use this opportunity that they are in place to go ahead and do some stuff with the text within those spans. So my span text, I'll go ahead and do a text align center, color, I'll do nice bright white text, font size, let's try 3ms, let's see if that's going to be too big for us. It's pretty big, but I think it's going to work. I'll dial it back anyway. Okay, looks pretty good. And I'll do a padding top of about 10 pixels. Just kind of push that down a little bit. Okay, so that's how I want it to look on hover. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with how that's looking. So back over on the code. See, I've already got these positioned absolutely, but instead of 0 from the top, I'm going to change this to 20 from the top. You'll see those cards will be pushed down a little bit further. And by the way, this is going to emphasize something I'll address in a minute here. Notice that there's my hyperlink and it's getting covered up by this non-hyperlink item, this block element here. So that's something that we're going to have to resolve. In fact, might as well resolve it now. I'm going to jump over to the HTML here real quick. And part of my problem is my span is not an anchor and I still want it to be clickable. So I think what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change these spans out to anchor tags. Okay, so now instead of spans, I've got anchor tags and I just have a little dummy hyperlink in there. And since those spans are gone and now I now have anchor tags, I'm going to have to change out the reference to the spans to a:, last child. So since I have two anchor tags in each list item, this will be the last child anchor. In fact, I can even write it out as within my list items, the last child anchor within my list items. Go and save this, head back over to the browser and refresh. And of course my text indent from before is screwing me up a little bit, but we can see that there's a hyperlink for the main image and then there's a hyperlink also for the cover up. All right, and for that text indent, pretty easy to fix here. I can just head over to where I've got that anchor and I can change this to list item anchor first child. So now my first child text is what has that text indent. Excellent. So now things are going very, very well. Let me go ahead and take my list items while I'm here and make sure those are overflow hidden because I don't want to see the card that's not on top of the list item. Head back down, and instead of 20 pixels, I'm going to make that 241 pixels. Save that, browser refresh, so I can't see the cards anymore. But now, when I hover over, so this is nav3, let me zoom in nice and big so you can see this. Nav3, list item hover. Within that, I'm going to take my anchor tags last child, and I'm going to set the top positioning to 0px because that's the ending state. So when I save this, browser refresh, hover over, there's that little pop-up. And of course, we like to see that transition effect into place. So I'll head up to the previous rule, my anchor last child, throw in a transition, and I'm changing the top, and I'll do it for 400 milliseconds. Ease in and out, save, browser refresh. Oops. And there is our cover-up illusion. So kind of a neat little system. So have fun with it.